Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. You know guys, I was going to take a break this week, really. I even told you about it in my last week's Dolly Paint video, that I was going to take some 4 or 5 days break after finishing all my holidays and Christmas special projects. Really, I was going to play some more with my new 3D printer. I was planning to finish some quick 3D modeling course, something like this. But then on the 31st of December, literally on the last day of the year, the post have delivered me this original Billie Eilish doll. Really, guys, I have ordered this doll back in September. Really, I've ordered it immediately the day they've announced the release. Originally, I was supposed to get it somewhere in November, I think, but then this date was postponed a couple of times. I've got three emails with this new date, with the changed date. Afterwards, I have really already forgotten about this doll because really it took too long to get it. And then suddenly on the very last day of the year, I've got the packaging, I've opened it, and there is my New Year's gift, this beautiful original Billie Eilish doll. And you know, for me right now, there is just no way to take a break with this brand new doll standing here in my studio unboxed. I was walking around this doll for 2 days, really like some cat around the box with snacks, because I really wanted to see what is inside, how this doll looks, because on these pictures, on picture on the box and on the pictures online, this doll looks absolutely fantastic. She looks really like Billie Eilish. So I really want to open the box and see how this doll looks, because here you can see just her face a little bit through this very tiny window. By the way, the box looks very pretty. I really love the design. I really love Billie peeking out through this tiny window. So guys, after 2 days of walking around, I have decided to put my camera on and to unbox this doll together with you. And then if I decide to repaint this doll, then yes, then I will still upload the video this week Friday, and then the next week Friday I will take a break, 100%, really. I promise it to myself. I really need some short 4-5 days weekend. So let's open this box, let's see what is inside. Maybe I don't have to repaint this doll, but anyway, if you see this video right now, then probably I have found something to do with it to make it a little bit better. So let's see what is inside, and then we will decide together what to do about this doll. First, let's probably take a short look at the box, because it looks pretty cool. Yeah, here is Billie peeking out through the window. Here is Billie. 10.5 inches fashion doll, fully posable, diorama display. This is very interesting because here on the back of this packaging, it also says open carefully, keep package to create your display. So this is how it's supposed to look probably after we assemble it. This is how the box looks from the inside. Yes, indeed, this is how our display holder is gonna look in the future, like this yellow wall from the music video. Here we have also some explanation how to install this display holder, and that we will have to cut some threads, remove them from her hair and from her outfit. No, anyway, this is not that much important. We will take a look at this display holder at the end of this makeover, at the photo shoot. So now let's take a look at the doll. And here is our Billie. Oh my god, she looks really cool. It's really like a real life Billie Eilish looking at you. Absolutely amazing. The face sculpt is 10 on 10. Absolutely fantastic. The outfit is also super cute. It's absolutely the same like the original. The shoes are also very, very cute. Yeah, here are lots of details. The real pockets. Here the hoodie. Here is also the real pocket.
Here is Velcro on the back to take it off. Yeah, here we're supposed to remove this thread. Voila, this is done. And the only thing that I can tell is that her hair is like very hard from all these styling products. I don't know, I think we're probably supposed to brush it first. Because look, they're really super hard from all this hair spray or hair gel or what they have used on it. Now, yeah, it's a little bit better, at least now it's not too hard, but now it's now it's too fluffy. I understand they put that much styling product on it to make it more flat, but all in all, I'm not convinced with the styling of her hair. Like, it's okay, but it makes her look a little bit like a doll, you know? The face looks good, especially the face sculpt, fantastic. Hair color is also good. But yeah, with the hairstyle I would play a little bit. Okay, let's take a look at her body, and the first thing that I see is that her neck is fully articulated. I don't know, probably never seen it really on these kinds of dolls. At least Barbie dolls, they never have this kind of a neck, you see? That is really moving like this. So she can kinda dance like this. Yeah, this is pretty cool. So her arms are fully bendable, very cool. Then her knees are also fully bendable. Her feet also, here is a joint. Yep, can she sit like this? No, not really. Still, you know, yoga Barbies, like Barbie made to move, they're a little bit more poseable. But anyway, it's a very decent result. So guys, now let's take a closer look at her face, because now we have to decide what to do, like, just what to do. To repaint her or not to repaint, or just to leave her like this, display her in my studio. I don't know, in one hand, her face is perfect. Like, she looks like Billie Eilish. Like, nobody would doubt who this doll represents. This is Billie Eilish 100%. But at the same time, it gives me very strong, you know, this BTS dolls feeling. It's an exactly the same kind of face application. I don't know if you can see it, but you can, like, if you look really close, you can really see the tiny pixels here. It's really like made by a printer. It looks like a, I don't know, like some sticker or something like this. It's been really printed on. You can see the pixels, especially you can see the pixels here. They are all these tiny details. The lips are quite okay, but the eyebrows, like all these tiny hairs, they're all pixelated. The irises here, the waterline, even the white of her eyes, it's all a little bit grainy. It's a little bit with tiny pixels. So, you know, also this doll, she doesn't have shadows, of course. Here is a little bit of blush on her cheeks. But that's it. There is no really shadows around her nose, nothing. Yeah, there are the eyelids, but that's it. I don't know, guys, maybe I am not that much realistic, maybe I think too good about myself, but I really think that I would be able to make this doll even better. Let's repaint her. Let's remove her face with acetone, and let's try to do a new face, trying to make this doll, I don't know, to look like Billie Eilish even more than she does already now. And you know also, guys, for me, just having a doll, it's just, 30% of a real experience. The real 100% fun I have just when I'm customizing dolls, just when I can change their faces, their hair, their outfits, stuff like this. Just when I can remake a doll completely, just in this case, I have a real 100% pure fun.
So, that's why I think, yes, we will go for it today, we will destroy this beautiful face, and we will draw a completely new face, trying to make her look like Billie Eilish even more. And also, you know, I've made already two Billie Eilish dolls on my channel, and both of the time I was really complaining about their face molds, because both of these dolls, or none of these dolls, actually looked like Billie Eilish. I mean, their facial features, facial proportions. So it was, of course, much more difficult for me trying to turn these dolls into Billie Eilish dolls. And this time I have finally a unique doll sculpted exactly like Billie Eilish, that has exactly her facial features, her nose, her eyes, her lips, and I just have to apply the shadows and, you know, draw the rest of the face. So yes, guys, that's it. I've made a decision. We're going to play with this doll today. I will take my acetone now and we will remove her beautiful face. Yeah, and then we'll try to draw another face, trying to make her look even more like Billie Eilish. And then the next week I will finally take my 5 days free. So the next week video I'm gonna skip. So subscribe, hit the bell button to get notified about my new upload in 2 weeks normally, and I will start working on this beautiful original real Billie Eilish doll. Well, I wanted to say that now we need to prepare this doll for the makeover, but actually, you know, she's already prepared. We have already undressed her. The hair I'm gonna keep because I like the color, but we will style them later in the end of this makeover. And you know, I will not even disconnect her head from the body today because I'm really scared to break this new mechanism. I don't know. Anyway, her outfit covers her body completely. She has this hoodie oversized, she has this oversized pants, so nobody would be able to see if her body has a little bit different skin tone than her face. So right now I think we will quickly remove her face with pure acetone. After this we'll protect her hair, protect her body with some kitchen plastic, and then we'll start the makeover. Well, guys, I was probably a little bit too positive about removing her makeup quickly, because actually these pixelated printed on faces are extremely difficult to remove. I've seen really a lot of damaged BTS doll faces online, because if you rub too hard, this paint will go off together with the upper layer of rubber. So we will suffer here for a while, I see it already, and the trick is to let acetone kinda work for a minute and then rub it gently. Then add some more acetone, wait a little bit, and then rub again. And you know, repeat it, and of course it might take a while, but this is the only way. No hard rubbing and a lot of kind of soaking in acetone. Well, and finally, after 45 minutes of rubbing and suffering, I can demonstrate you the clean face. Super, finally, I'm so happy, you cannot imagine. So now let's seal the face with Mr. Super Clear sealant, and then we can start drawing. And I start, like always, with sketching the face, the eyes, the eyebrows, the lips, and after this we will draw the shadows using soft pastels. First, I apply a layer of lighter pastels, and the color of these pastels, it will become actually very similar to her existing skin tone after I spray it with another layer of sealant. And then on top of it, I will apply darker pastels, and from my experience, the pastels will blend better and we will get kind of more perfect transition between the lighter and the darker areas of the face. Because if you apply straight these dark pastels to the doll's face, you might get some patchy areas. Even though these pastels are very easy to blend, but you know, when you apply it on top of these kind of lighter pastels, you get an absolutely perfect, flawless result. After this, I'm highlighting the middle of her face using white pastels, and then I will add a touch of pink blush to the cheeks. Okay, now I'm satisfied with the basic shadows, and it means we can start drawing her eyes, eyebrows and lips with my watercolor pencils. I'm using, of course, the whole bunch of reference pictures today, taken from different angles, you know, showing the face completely from different sides. And there are two interesting details that I've noticed looking at these reference pictures for hours. And first of all, one of the Billie's eyebrows, it always looks more wild and more bushy than another. I can see it on all the pictures, and it's a very interesting and very individual detail, I think. And also, strangely enough, Billie's lips on the earlier pictures look bigger and kind of puffier than on more recent ones. I don't know, is it just makeup or light and camera angle? Or maybe, I don't know, just a process of becoming an adult and becoming less puffy in some way? I don't really think she used lip fillers at the age of 15, so it's something else, but it's a very interesting thing to notice. In the end, we can add a touch of gloss to her eyes and lips, and after this, I think I can call the face finished. I'm quite happy about it, so now let's take a look at her hair. And first of all, I remove this plastic, all this protection. And then I will clean the hairline from some, you know, residue of the sealant and pastels. And then we will style her hair using a hair dryer and also using my hair straightener. So guys, here is finally my version of this Billie Eilish doll, and I will let you to decide which version is better. Please don't forget to leave your opinion, your vote under this video, which mini version of Billie Eilish do you prefer, the original one or the one customized by me. But I can tell you honestly that something strange has happened to me, to my perception, over the last 2 days, because, you know, when I just unboxed this doll, I was totally amazed by how much she looked like Billy. And now, after these 2 days, she doesn't look like Billy at all to me. I don't know, I see nearly no likeness, really zero likeness at the moment. And it feels really strange that my view, my perception could change that quickly and so dramatically. I don't know, probably it happened because I was looking at Billy's pictures non-stop for 2 days and I've learned her face out of my head. I don't know, was it for you also like this, or your vision of the original doll hasn't changed after this video? I know this is some strange question to ask, but I don't know, it just feels strange to me. But anyway, I'm very happy with the end result. It was, of course, a shorter makeover today, but this doll was nearly perfect and I had nothing else to change except for the face. The outfit and the shoes, they're just perfect, and her hair is also probably the best what you can get on a doll. But it was interesting anyway, for me at least. I hope it was interesting for you as well, because there are not that many celebrity dolls with this detailed face mold that gives you an opportunity to work on a more hyper-realistic face-up. That's why it was very interesting for me today. I also wanted to ask you to share this doll on social media and to tag Billy on it, because who knows, maybe she would see it eventually. You know, it would be absolutely fantastic, but yeah, there is absolutely no chance to get her attention without our joint effort, without the community help. So, and that was my doll transformation of the week, guys. I really hope you enjoyed it today. And if so, please don't forget to support my art here on YouTube with your likes. Of course, subscribe to my channel, hit the bell button to get notified about my new doll repaint videos. And I will see you already very soon, normally in 2 weeks, because like I've told you in the beginning, I'm gonna take a couple of days free. And then in 2 weeks, we're going to repaint a new doll. So, see you very soon, guys. Love you. Bye.